Hi everyone, this is Kara Zaller, licensed nutritionist, excited to tell you about a new product that I found on the market, cauliflower pizza crust, which I think there's a lot of these on the market. However, none of them meet my standards so far, but this one seemed to. For example, let me read you the ingredients. Cauliflower, fresh cauliflower, sesame seed flour, sunflower seed flour, olive oil, nutritional yeast, basil, psyllium husk powder, garlic, sea salt. All simple, real whole food ingredients. So from the outside, I thought this would be a great product. So I bought it, took it home, went to cook it, and this is what it looks like. Not really like a regular pizza crust, so I was a little skeptical at first. So what you do is you just take this and you put it on a pizza pan that has the holes inside. So I did that, and you bake it for about 10 to 12 minutes. So I did that. And then you can put whatever topping you want. So I decided I was gonna use pizza sauce, and then I was gonna add in a little bit of artichoke hearts and basil, roasted peppers, a little arugula, and some pepperoni. Since again, remember, I do not do dairy, so I did not add cheese, but this looked like it would be a good product that you can add cheese if you do consume dairy. So I cooked it, and this is what it looks like. Of course, I ate this part. I added a little bit too much sauce, it sort of spilled over. I didn't want to cover everything with all the ingredients that I like to top with, because this way, if I wanted to cook it again and I wanted to eat it with a different topping, this gave me the flexibility that I can change up my toppings. Anyway, this is what it looked like. The outside seemed to get crusty, but the inside part was a little flimsy and soft. So when I ended up eating it, I ended up having to, you know, roll it up almost like a pita pocket type of product. But the taste was actually really delicious, so I am impressed with this product. I think also I might have cooked it, I used parchment paper underneath. I think if I just left it on the pizza pan itself, maybe the entire thing would have gotten crispy. I'm not sure, maybe you guys can check it out and see if that works for you. In the meantime, this was pretty neat, a little different flavor for me. So I give it a thumbs up. I really like it. Thanks for watching.